Flatwork 101. Flatwork is a common, very broad term for any horizontal flat concrete work that is normally placed or laid down to form a surface. It could be a concrete slab, sidewalk, patio, driveway, or even parking lot. These solid surfaces rest all around every day with little or no recognition, and yet without them, our lives would be lacking. Flatwork makes up the surfaces of our lives, inside and outside, from the bottom to the top. Basement prep. Let's lay our flatwork starting inside and below. Make sure underground plumbing has passed inspection and sump croc is installed. In most cases, there will be a green or blue tag attached to the plumbing in basements indicating if the plumbing is approved, and a red tag if it is not. If you see a red tag, notify your foreman immediately. Make a story stick. This is done to establish the height of the gravel as well as the concrete you'll be pouring. A story stick is basically a measuring pole used throughout the basement flatwork process. You'll use one whether you're working on grading or pouring. Get out your shovels and rakes and level the gravel, keeping a close eye on your story stick to monitor the stone height. As you proceed, if there is a need to remove or add stone for correct concrete thickness, it is done at this time. Mark lines along the wall at the height of the finished concrete. Then use a chalk line to snap lines along the entire length of every wall. You're going to want to keep things dry, right? Of course. Cut the vapor barrier or plastic to the correct size. A vapor barrier is used for damp proofing. Typically, a roll of plastic that is cut to size. This barrier blocks both moisture and radon in the ground below from entering the house. As you place the barrier, make sure it is as tight as possible to the concrete foundation walls or anything else it might go against. The seams of each piece should have at least 6 inches of overlap. Every seam needs to be taped with vapor barrier tape. It is absolutely critical that this is done correctly. If it's not, you'll know about it. The vapor barrier needs to be inspected per state code before the concrete is poured. Garage prep. Now that you've completed that task, let's prep the garage and stoop. Establish heights. Normally, this is done by starting at the garage door trim in front and then figuring 1/4 inch per foot of a pitch to the back of the garage. Then, gravel or stone can be roughed into place to be compacted by a jumping jack or plate compactor. Whichever you use, it means you're pushing the stuff down hard and tight. The stone or gravel height we are trying to achieve in most cases is 4 inches below the chalk line. Once the final grade is checked and double checked with string line and a tape measure and the final compaction is complete, we're on to drill your dowels and place your headers. A dowel is a metal 2-foot-long, 1/2-inch round piece of steel, otherwise known as number 4 rebar. These puppies aren't getting bent in anyone's hands. Dowel holes are drilled with a hammer drill and half-inch bit 4 inches below chalk line every 3 feet to help support the floor. Once holes are drilled, dowels can be hammered into place. Door headers are installed by use of hammer drill and a 3/16 hammer drill bit. The door header must be the correct height and straight as an arrow. They are held in place with 16 penny duplex nails and wire, and they're straightened with steel stakes. Looking good, let's head to the stoop. Stoop prep. Heights and pitch are typically established by your foreman or a senior member of the team. The step from inside the house to the top of the stoop must not be any larger than 8 inches, and then a pitch of 1/4 per foot to the outside edge of the stoop. A drip ledge can be installed level with the top of the foundation wall of a stoop. In most cases, the drip ledge is 1.5 inches wide. The material used is a 2x4 cut to the correct length that is then fastened with a hammer drill using 3/16-bit 16-penny single-headed nail and wire every 16 to 20 inches. After the ledge is installed, the stoop can be formed with proper wood material, such as a 2x12 or 2x10 material, and fastened to the drip ledge with 16-penny duplex nails. Grading or placing of gravel to correct height, we should achieve 4 inches of concrete thickness. Then, if there is no exposed concrete wall at the house side, it'll be underpinned with number 4 rebar for support. And with that, it's time to step back. Not that your work is over. Take this time to prep work steps for tomorrow's pouring of concrete. basement, garage, and stoop concrete pour. Unload all your concrete tools. Chutes, pouring snout, strike-offs, bull float, rakes, shovels, zip strip, and anything else you feel you might need to complete this task. With the direction of your foreman or senior team member, set up chutes and start pouring that concrete. The concrete is ready to be raked as close to the chalk lines as you're able to. Then, it's time to set wet screeds with your story stick. Screed. What a fun word. A wet screed is created in two ways. One is by using a hand float to smooth the concrete at the chalk lines, and the other is done by leveling small areas with your story stick and then using a 2x4 or an aluminum strike-off to create a long, flat area at the proper height. Now you can strike off the concrete to proper height by spanning the two wet screeds. A zip strip is a T-shaped piece of plastic that is placed in the wet concrete while it is being leveled. Generally, we want the zip strip placed every 12 feet or so, and ideally at any corners of the foundation wall. The top of the plastic strip is removed, leaving the piece that'll eventually make the concrete crack. If done correctly, the concrete will crack in a straight line, and the zip strip will never be seen or heard from again, just like many former members of the Mafia. Once struck off, the concrete needs to be bull floated to a smooth, consistent surface. Then, just continue repeating the process until you're done. And you won't need to change your technique from basement to garage. The processes are basically the same with your garage floor pour, just without as many chutes. Basement and garage finish, aka hard trowel finish. They say to become a master of anything, it takes 10,000 hours of practice. And while being a master of flatwork may not be something many set out to achieve, by learning to use a finishing machine and a variety of hand tools such as floats, trowels, sliders, knee boards, edgers, jointers, and brooms, it can be done. And being a master of anything is worth bragging about. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. We're not there yet. There's finishing to do. On any hard trowel floor, before you start the finishing process, you want to make sure that the surface is solid enough to walk on while barely leaving an imprint. When the floor is at this point, start at the edges, going around smoothing out the concrete on knee boards with a float and trowel, inch by inch, back and forth. For my money, there is no finer meditation. Now, time to put your machine to use. Set the blades low, throttle up the machine a bit, and start working it back and forth in a right to left motion. The edges of the floor normally take 3 to 4 passes until they're finished. The finishing machine will also need to be used 3 to 4 times before the work is done. Although it may sound easy, this skill can take years to learn. Taking your time and learning from other experienced tradesmen is key to learning this craft. The only waves we want to see are against your fishing boat when you take a vacation after completing your flatwork. This machine process is repeated until any floor, basement, or garage is a smooth, hard, flat, consistent surface. A job well done. Now, let's head to our flatwork outside. Exterior Flatwork 101. While we live our lives walking on the flatwork in our basements and garages, our feet get plenty of more miles across driveways, sidewalks, steps, and patios. While the process is similar, there are differences. This is a step-by-step look at exterior flatwork. Prep all areas, determining the size and shape, and establish height and pitch. Established areas can be roughed in by use of bobcat, shovel, and rake. Then, stone or gravel will need to be compacted by use of jumping jack or plate compactor. Forming. In simple terms, concrete forms are nothing more than a solid barrier that holds concrete in place or forces concrete to assume a certain shape. Think of them as the levee walls there to protect the land, in this case, your driveway or sidewalk. Use 2x4 or 2x6 wood material following a string line for correct height, pitch, and straightness. Secure the wood in place by using steel pins and fastening with 8 or 16 penny nails. Once everything is formed up correctly, grading can begin. Once again, this is done by use of string line and tape measure to achieve correct thickness of concrete, generally 4 inches thick. It must be compacted a final time. Dowels are secured to the foundation wall at garage front or any other place that exterior concrete meets foundation, 4 inches below the concrete surface by use of hammer drill and half-inch bit. Then, dowels can be put into place. Now, sometimes concrete needs a barrier from other slabs. This is achieved with the use of expansion. It is a 4-inch wide foam material placed between a foundation wall and concrete, or between two different sections of concrete. Pouring exterior concrete. We've reached the final steps of our flatwork. The pouring of the concrete. Pouring exterior concrete, much like other concrete, is done so by using strike-offs, bull floats, hand floats, brooms, edgers, and jointers. Start pouring concrete, leveling it with rakes or shovels as it fills the intended area. Strike off the top with the correct size strike-off, smoothing with bull float until pouring is complete. Finish the concrete by hand with floats, edgers, jointers, and finish broom. Appreciate the craftsmanship only achievable by hand. This human touch leaves an impression in the flatwork none will consider, but you can take pride in. Once the concrete is hand finished, it can be broomed to a nice, light, even consistency. And lastly, the final touch, finish off your work by spraying an even sealer over the whole surface. Typically, all surfaces except the basement are sprayed with a sealer. Some exceptions are made in cold weather. And there it is, your handcrafted flatwork. A piece of art in its own right, and done correctly, one that will exist for many, many years to come.